What's up, guys? Today I was supposed to do like a what I eat in a day, but I just don't feel like it anymore. Oh. Look at that. All the ingredients I was going to use to cook with conveniently laid out on the countertop. Well, it looked like I have no choice. So, let's do a what I eat in a day. Let's make my infamous protein oats. So first, get your bowl. Whatever dish you want, just make sure it's microwave or oven safe. We're going to be using a microwave today, but get your bowl and a scale. And to that, add 80 grams of oats. That sounds like a lot, but trust me, it's not. It goes down pretty quick if you have a slightly above average appetite. I could probably eat like 4 of these bowls, but I choose not to. Okay, your next ingredient, I usually just mix all the dry ingredients before I add the wet ingredients. So, get your chia seeds. If you don't have chia seeds, use ground flax seeds. If you don't have that either, it doesn't really matter. I just add these for the energy. Like, there's not many health benefits that come out of this. I mean, 4 grams of protein, it's not bad. Just to have it right there. You're gonna add 12 grams of that if you are adding chia seeds. Next, I like to add a little bit of salt. Oh, yeah. That will just increase the flavor once it's all heated up and ready to go. Okay, now that you've got all your dry ingredients, I'm gonna use a plastic fork because I can't seem to find a spoon. Just mix it up a little bit. Alright. Now add your wet ingredients. So, sugar-free syrup. This stuff is a lifesaver. It's a sweetener, so it's going to make it taste even better. And it's not added calories. You could use stevia, but I don't recommend. This stuff's a little bit more natural. So, you're going to add 15 milliliters of that. And that goes a long way, honestly. Yeah. If you don't have vanilla extract, what are you doing with your life? Like, do you not have parents? I'm sorry if you don't, but just add a little bit of that. Like, it literally, okay, well. You probably want more than that. I'd say around a teaspoon would be a good enough amount. I did not have that much. But it's okay, because I can handle a little bitterness, unlike you. That's why you're here. Now, add about 120 milliliters of almond milk, and this next part might be controversial, but you know, you can do with or without. You do 180 milliliters of almond milk, or you can do 60 added milliliters to 120 milliliters of water. Ooh, just barely off, 188. All right, mix that all up, because it's ready for the microwave. Alright, so once you've microwaved it once for about a minute to a minute 30, stir it up and microwave it again. Alright. Usually, once I put it in the second time, that's whenever I clean everything up, I put up all the ingredients. But since I'm recording it, I kind of did that already. So like, I feel like I'm out of routine. Anyways, let's get to it. So your next ingredient is not peanut butter. Newsflash. Right, get your protein out, all right? Put it on the scale. You're gonna learn something here if you don't already do this. Zero it out with the scoop, not in the tub. So zero it out, scoop out 30 grams. You're gonna be like, what? But you're taking it out. Well, it's gonna say a negative. It's going to say negative 30 grams. Well, guess what? That's still 30 grams in there. And if you don't already do this, start doing it. All right. Get your scoop. This right here is horrible. Like, if you leave it like this and try to stir it up, it's not going to be fun. So what I do is I add about, I don't know, 20 milliliters to 40 milliliters of almond milk, sometimes water. So I just add a little more moisture. So it'll stir. And what do you think you do next? Stir. Until you have somewhat of a decent mixture. It's not going to be perfect every time unless you literally go on, like, on the dot with your liquid measurements. That's the beauty of it. Some days you'll get a little bit runnier, some days you'll get a little bit harder. It's called finding perfection in the imperfections. Actually, that doesn't even really make sense at all. But don't worry about it. Next, you're gonna add peanut butter. And guess what? You can do the same thing here. I'm gonna use this fork because I didn't just put my mouth on it. Do about 8 to 16 grams. 8 grams is around 50 calories, and then 16 grams of peanut butter is around 95 calories, which is what I usually do. So we get that right on first try. And if you lick the fork, the calories are gonna be the same because you're just eating all the peanut butter. So don't stress if you eat the stuff off of the spoon. Trust me, it's not worth it. Why am I putting stuff up right now? I'm supposed to be teaching you. Got distracted. Last thing, but not least, actually, it is the least amount. Chocolate chips. I usually do semi-sweet because it's not too bitter and it blends really well. So if you add like literally 4 or 5 grams of this, it's not only enough chocolate chips, it's like 20 calories. So I highly recommend this and it makes it look prettier. So you're already in a good mood once you pop these suckers in. And they don't weigh a lot. So you can really go crazy on chocolate chips. And I'm pretty sure it's healthy for you to have a little bit of chocolate every day. But that's it. This is what it looks like. Pretty bueno. I'm gonna eat it now. Oh, look at this. So Zest Tea is a carbonated tea brand that they sent me out like a 12 pack of these. It's really awesome. They sent me 2 of each flavor. And I think you get the same bundle if you just go online and order it. But, like, I don't know how to explain it. So, if you've ever had an actual sparkling water, like, where it's flavored, that's basically what this is. It's like flavored water, but it's flavored tea. But it's carbonated, so it's more like a Celsius. If you've ever had a Celsius, this is the closest thing to it. And it's so good. And these flavors, passion fruit berry. I don't know what that tastes like. I don't know what it's supposed to taste like, honestly. But I think it tastes good. Highly recommend. If you want some, I'll probably leave a link in the description. Or you can just look up Zest Tea. I don't think anybody else is naming their stuff that because, you know, in this day and age, you know what people refer to that to. But let's eat this oatmeal, and I always eat an apple for breakfast. It's just good for you. It's like having coffee in solid form, according to science, you know, the amount of natural sugars that are in this. The next time you see me, it'll probably be the next meal. If not, then I'm probably in a house fire. Hopefully that's not foreshadowing. Meal 2, steak and rice. This is a great combo, I swear, you gotta try it. I've already got the rice poured out, it's 150 grams. I didn't want you to have to see me struggle to get exactly 150 grams, because trust me, it's no fun, and you probably get impatient. I usually do 150 grams of rice and 4 ounces of steak, because I like to have a high ratio of rice to steak. It's better to have more carbs in a meal than protein anyways. I mean, everybody knows that, I hope. I've already diced up my steak a little bit, so I'm just going to add these little pieces until it's 4 ounces, and boom. Alright, we got 4 ounces. I'm going to microwave this for a minute and a half. Can't just have meat and carbs. Got to add a little bit of seasoning. I always like to add a little bit of salt, a smidge of lime juice. Have you ever had those tacos? Like steak tacos, and they've always got a little bit of lime zest in it. Some liquid aminos. If you don't have this, you can add soy sauce, but I don't recommend.
Liquid aminos are supposed to be a healthier alternative to soy sauce. And this isn't as, like, pungent. And then lastly, I'll add some pepper. Gourmet stuff right here. Obviously, it doesn't look that good, but it's all about taste and what it does for my body. While I'm searching for a YouTube video, it's probably going to be Will Tennyson. I'm going to plug Legion Greens. This is what I'm going to be drinking while I eat this. I don't know. I mean, the savoriness of this meal mixed with, like, the kind of bitter plantiness of the greens, it just kind of goes together. If you're not drinking greens, I highly recommend, especially if you're not eating enough vegetables, because you got to get those micronutrients. I recommend. Link in bio. Use code CAMO for. Enough said. Let's eat. I could watch C-Day. It's important. I went with Will Tennyson. Most of my humor comes from him, you know? He's just so dry, and all of his innuendos are perfect. Alright, I'm gonna finish the rest of this off camera. I'll see you at meal three. It's the best meal of the day. Pre-workout meal. Right, just like meal two, get yourself an oven-safe bowl or microwave-safe. I'm going to be using the microwave once again. If you've been following me for more than a day, you probably know what this is. It's my infamous cake bowl. I literally make it before every workout. Get yourself 30 to 40 grams of oatmeal. I'm going to go ahead and go with 40. 150 calories if using these kind of oats. A scoop of protein. Scoop out negative 30 grams. All right, that's how you know it's 30. Like, the texture of this protein is just so satisfying to look at. I don't know why it is. Ah, dude, how do I keep forgetting? Gotta have the cheese seeds. Alright. Add 12 grams of chia seeds. If you don't have these, go get them, because these honestly make the bowl. Like, this is a huge part of the texture of it and everything. It kind of gives it a little bit of fluffiness somehow. I have no idea how, but just trust me on this. Add some maple syrup. Go ahead and go with 15 milligrams. If you want to do a full serving size, it might be a little too sweet. I don't know if that's a thing. I don't know if something could be too sweet. But anyways, once you've added that, 1/4 teaspoon of baking powder. If you don't have any of this, then you're not going to get a cake. You're just going to have a bowl of oatmeal. You don't want that. I mean, you might want that. But go ahead and add your baking powder. Last but not least, 1/2 cup of almond milk. I'm always using almond milk. And there's nothing wrong with that. Stir it up until you have a very wet batter. It's not going to look just like cake batter, obviously, but it's also not going in the oven for 40 minutes. It's going in the microwave for a minute 30. So let's go ahead and do that. Think she's done. It's not the prettiest, but it does taste good, I promise. All you have to do now is add your toppings. And I usually go with 8 grams of peanut butter. I stay low on the peanut butter for this one. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna do 16 because there's nothing wrong with a little bit more peanut butter. It's a good fat. Honestly, it's just good for you. Who cares about the extra 50 calories? With that, I'll add some Flavor King chocolate donut flavor. It's artificial and it tastes just like a chocolate donut, I guess. To round it all off, I add a sprinkle of chocolate chips. Just for the aesthetic. More appetizing. That is it. Doesn't look the prettiest. This isn't my prettiest batch, but that's okay. It's gonna taste amazing. So let's eat this. All right. Woo, that looks good. Almost forgot the bagel with the cream cheese. How could I be so silly? Let's do a little taste test. I already know it schmacks. Mm. as good. I use chocolate peanut butter protein because it goes well with the peanut butter. And once, like, once you add the peanut butter, add it, like, right after it's out of the microwave so it melts. So good. The creaminess is unmatched. Pro tip, if you're using, like, a cookie protein powder or vanilla-based, like, anything that's not chocolate peanut butter, I would recommend using Biscoff spread for your topping because it mixes so much better. I use Biscoff for most of my cake bowls, but lately I've been stuck on chocolate and peanut butter because that's like my favorite combo. Reese's is my favorite candy, so it just makes sense. I'm going to eat this, watch a little bit of YouTube, and in about 45 minutes to an hour, I will take my pre-workout, and I'll show you that as well, like my whole routine, mentality and everything, all right? So, dude, I need to go to LA. Watching all these vlogs of people in LA just looks so fun. Someone trying to book a plane ticket for me? All right, let's do it. All right, you know the drill. Sparkling water with some Legion Pro. It's a really good combo. I recommend you try it. It's probably good with other pre-workouts, but I've only tried it with Legion. Actually, I tried it with Gorilla before. Not good. Gorilla, it's better on its own. This stuff, it's like crystallized. Like, the pre-workout's crystallized, and it just blends so well with carbonated water. But yeah, let's do it. So I usually do about 6 to 8 ounces of this. Just pour it right out. And then I do, I'd say a scoop to a scoop and a half of this. I'll only do like 250 to 300 milligrams of caffeine. I don't need that much. I usually don't even use caffeine because, like, with ADHD, caffeine does nothing at all. I'm going to add some performance surge to this just so, you know, like, I get the most out of my workout today. Not feeling the best lately mentally, so I really need a good workout. So let's do it. And when you mix it up, it's kind of fizzy at first, but it calms down. You just got to give it time. I think the performance surge doesn't homogenize very well at all. But the thing is that it's unflavored, so you don't even taste it. Give it a little taste test. The only way I can describe it is like a strawberry energy drink, if that exists. I'm sure it does. That's what it tastes like. It tastes like an energy drink without it being as unhealthy. And it gets me going. It gets me in the right mindset. Because here's why I like doing this so much. During school, I live off of energy drinks. It's a horrible habit, but it's the only way I can get any focus. Like, I used to take medication for it. It never worked. As soon as I started drinking energy drinks, I could actually focus in school. It's like a trigger. I don't know. There's a natural ingredient that helps me. So every time I take one of these, I like go back to that zone where I just feel focused. And of course, I've got other supplements that I take to help me, which I'll show you right now. So here I've got Mito2 Max, Cypress Essential Oil by doTERRA, and Intune. Intune and Cypress are a great combo because this helps me focus. Like, actually, it's third-party tested, it's science-based. If you apply in the right spots on your body, you will feel more focused. It's just how it works. And then here's Cypress. Cypress, there's like a chemical in it that helps relieve stress and increases blood flow. So overall, you just feel more relaxed and better. And then the Mito2 Max, that Mito, like mitochondria, it boosts the mitochondrial process, like where ATP is produced, and it just gives you more energy overall. So with all of this combined, I almost never have a bad workout. I go in there, sometimes I might not mentally feel okay, but I'm still having a good workout. Like, energy and everything is there, but mentally is where I struggle, and I'm working on it. But I always go back to a deeper place in my mind, and it gets me through the workout every time. These just help. Whenever I work out with zero supplements, I never feel any good. I don't know why. It's probably something that I need to work on. But for now, we're just gonna keep riding with this until I'm where I wanna be.
Sound good? All right. I'm going to hopefully see you at the gym. If not, then something happened. See ya.
Listen, if you feel self-doubt, that's okay. That's part of it. But you can change it now. You can have self-hope. You can build yourself. You can create this new image in your head. The best version of yourself. And it's achievable. As long as you stay consistent, as long as you keep fighting every day, just do the same thing every day, you're always getting better. Daily. That's right. People won't see the change like you do. If you're doing it every day, then you're always improving. While other people are sitting back watching like, how is he doing all that? It's because you're putting in the work. The more work you put in, the better off you're going to be. Because people are going to sit back and watch the whole time. They're going to watch you succeed. They're not putting in the work. They're just learning that they don't have it in them like you. You got it. You can be the best version of yourself right now. You already are. You're better than everybody else with this mentality. Just go. Get up. Go do something with your life. Go learn. Go get better at it. I don't care what it is. Go to the gym. That's right. That's your sacred place. That's where you can think all the thoughts that you want to think and get better. Right now. I believe in you. Believe in yourself. I love you. Now let's get in the gym, baby.
Praise to the almighty high power, power. Me and my niggas. 3 hours to my long hours. You lay me down to sleep, I wake up in the clean. Phyllis.
Plenty pussies throwing pellet guns at me. Paranoia make it more than difficult for me to sleep. Pinnacle, I know I beat. Centerfold, I know I got. But they hate to frame me as the Mona Lisa of hip hop. So retaliation is a must. When we bend the block, my niggas jumping out the roof. Do, 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 do. Drive past guns, flash, shooting up the charts too. BKDO, deeper D&T inside my suit. Walk inside the label, struck up.
Bro, I gotta poop. Like, I could poop myself, he said. Like, I'm not kidding.
C4 everywhere, C4 everywhere. I got three oars with me, it smell like Dior and Derriere. Decoys die slow, you can detour to heaven stairs. So walk inside L's dungeon, I just might derail something. They pussies, I smell something. You dish on the daily, niggas, you pushing up daisy. I push the gas on Mercedes, nickel. Came in this game with a rolly chain and a dream. Became reality, made some casualties, my chopper scream. And now we dumping out the roof.
I almost pooped myself.
Do, 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 do. Drive past guns, blast, shooting up the charts too. Me KDOT, put D&T inside my suit. Walk inside the label, struck a match and then I blew. Now we dumping out the roof. Do, 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 do. Drive past guns, blast, shooting up the charts too. Me KDOT, put D&T inside my suit. Walk inside the label, struck a match and then I blew. Niggas that thought that good kid gon' flop, or I might go pop, or your bitch won't drop. Need when my shit drop. Y'all too infatuated with the fucking numbers, which make it easy for me to divide and conquer. I come from Compton, we ain't have it all. Smoke a spacing inside the cafeteria hall, and I'm putting fear in you all. See your skeleton shaking, jump out your body, you Ricky Bobby until you're naked.
Bro, I'll be honest, I haven't hit legs in like almost a month. This is killing me. And I haven't even done anything yet. Holy crap.
Yeah, I pray to God this week I be putting up bombs. I pray to God this beat is good enough for Sean. If not J. Cole, your shit is trash. Well, at least my opinion just made everyone laugh. This is where we at? I guess it's entertainment. I guess this is speculation making a classic came with. If I ain't have the patience, I'd probably self-destruct. Real people want real music. The jig is up.
By the way, the poop earlier, bro, I gotta poop. Like, I could poop myself to set. Like, I'm not kidding. It just turned into a couple farts, but they smelled really bad.
Your worst fears confirmed. We laugh as you crash and burn. The real is back. K-Dot, it's your turn. Take your victory lap. King Cole, salute the cop that's on. Can't catch you.
As the sky's falling, the wind is calling. Stand for something to die in the morning. The city hail King Kendrick Lamar. The world hail King Kendrick Lamar.
And now we dumping out the roof. Drive past guns, blast, shooting up the charts too. Me KDOD, put DAD inside my suit. Walk inside the label, struck a match and then I blew. Now we dumping out the roof. Drive past guns, blast, shooting up the charts too. Me KDOD, put DAD inside my suit. Walk inside the label, struck a match and then I blew.
I forgot how much I love like that, bro. I mean, I just look massive whenever I do legs. I don't know what happens, but it happens. Also, shout out to Void for these awesome shorts and Devo Apparel for the awesome shirt and the hat. I mean, let's just get home and eat because your boy's starving.
All right, so we got dinner. So I've made a ground turkey and rice bowl with pasta sauce. Don't knock it till you try it. And with that, I've got anabolic ice cream. See that? That's how you know it's official. I'll leave a link down in the description. It's the Greg Doucette recipe. If you don't already know it, it's pretty easy. It's like 150 grams equal parts for frozen strawberries and ice cubes. Scoop of protein, a little bit of liquid, like 120 milliliters of milk, and some xanthan gum. And that's what expands it and makes it into ice cream. I used some Legion whey protein. This meal right here alone is only 600 calories right here. This is 600 calories, like a little over. So it's a pretty solid post-workout meal. Quite a bit of protein, little carbs. And then for dessert, since my parents decided to bring it home, I've got some crumble cookie. This is a 520 calorie cookie. That's crazy, right? Yeah, I'm gonna eat this. And that's all I've got for you today. I hope you enjoyed. Like and subscribe and leave a funny comment down below. They always make my day. Love you. See you around.